I'm KJ from Low Poly Models, and today we're going to dive into the exciting world of skin wearables for Decentraland. If you're not familiar with Decentraland, it's a metaverse platform where people can create, experience, own, and sell digital content like wearables. When it comes to wearables, skins are one of the most interesting to make because they give us the most flexibility and creativity compared to other wearables. Skins are the type of digital wearable that completely replaces the base avatar. So if you're interested in making your own skin wearables, you're in the right place. In this tutorial, we'll walk through the entire process from start to finish. We'll be using the 3D software Blender for most of the creative process. I'll link some Blender tutorials down below if you'd like to learn more about how it works. Just know that it's the best 3D software out there, it's free and it's open source. And if you stick around until the end, I'll show you how to publish your wearables to Decentraland, where you can wear, gift, and even sell them if you choose. Before we start creating our skin wearable, let's go over some of the basic principles to make sure you're set up for success. Firstly, it's important to keep in mind that skin wearables can take on many different forms, from animals to objects to abstract concepts. However, they do need to be roughly the same size as default avatars, and they must be created in a T-pose. So the arms need to be outstretched and the legs must go straight down. This can actually be quite a fun limitation to work with, as it encourages creativity and outside-the-box thinking. For example, a few years back, I made a jellyfish skin that has tentacles in a T-pose so that it fits within these limitations, but it doesn't look like a humanoid character. When you're creating your skin, you have a maximum of 5,000 triangles to work with in 3D, and you can use up to 5 images to texture it. Ideally, these pictures should be 512 by 512 pixels, or smaller powers of 2, like 256 or 128 pixels. Once you've created your 3D model and applied the textures, the final step will be to rig it to the base Decentraland armature. This will allow your skin to move and animate alongside the avatar. Rigging, weight painting, and skinning are different words for exactly the same thing. So if you hear me using different words, don't worry, I'm talking about exactly the same thing. Lastly, before we dive into it, you can find links to all of the assets and the documentation that we're going to be talking about in the description down below. To start making your wearable, it's helpful to have some reference images or sketches ready and to keep them close by for inspiration. For this tutorial, we used Midjourney AI to generate the concept art for our skin wearable to give us kind of a better idea of what we wanted to do, and also to save some time there. Since our skin wearable is a character, we're going to use a base avatar mesh just to help us define the main shapes of the clothing without having to worry too much about the anatomy underneath to begin with. We could use one of the Decentraland default base avatars for this, but for fun, let's try with a different one. We'll use a cool high poly mesh provided by the Over augmented reality platform. Next, we'll block in the adjustments and add some clothing. Once we're happy with the look, we'll do a retopology to ensure that all the geometry is nice and clean and ready to be animated smoothly in Decentraland. It's important to make sure the 3D model is watertight, which means that every vertex is connected to another one. This will help avoid clipping issues and make the weight painting process easier. Once the model is ready, it's a good idea to apply or remove any modifiers, join any separate meshes with Ctrl or Command J, and make sure to clear any parents with Ctrl P. Then always apply all transforms to the model by pressing Ctrl and A with the model selected in the 3D viewport and selecting Apply All Transforms. Now it's time to parent your model to the Decentraland default armature. So select the model, then the armature, and press Ctrl P to parent them. A window with different parenting options will pop up. Any of the armature deform options are valid, but the automatic weights option is my go-to. From here, we can go into pose mode and see how the skin wearable already moves with the armature. But there are probably some things that are going to need some adjustments on closer inspection. So to refine the rigging, select the armature, then the model, and go into weight paint mode. Here you can select different bones by clicking while pressing Control and painting more or less weight for each bone. If your mesh is symmetrical, you can do this just on one side and then mirror the weights to the other side to save time. When working with abstract or non-human models, it's usually easier to weight paint them by mentally dividing them into a series of cubes that represent the bones areas of influence. Then you can weight paint the mesh based on these kind of blocked out cube sections. And once you've done that, you can use the blur tool to smooth out the areas in between those blocks. To test the weight painting and see how your skin is animated in Decentraland, export the model as a GLB file with these settings checked. Selected objects, plus Y up, UVs, normals, vertex colors, and skinning. Head over to the builder and upload your wearable to a collection. Now you can try out different emotes with your wearable in the preview, and you can also jump in world to see walking, running, and jumping and get a better preview of the materials. Once you're happy with the weight painting, it's time to mirror any symmetrical areas that you didn't fully weight before. To do this, in weight paint mode, select the bone whose influence you want to mirror to the other side and corresponding bone. Then go to the object data properties, and in vertex groups, click the arrow and select copy vertex group. That will create a duplicate of the bone's influence. Next, I like to partially rename the new vertex group to the other side. So if it says right arm, for example, we'll change it to left arm. And then we'll click on the arrow again and choose mirror vertex group. Now the influence is on the other side, and the next step is to connect this to the correct bone data. So let's go ahead and delete the original left bone from the list of vertex groups. Scroll down to the copy we made before and remove the underscore copy from the name so that it has the same name as the vertex group that we just deleted. Now, if you select the bone on the other side and move it, you'll see the corresponding vertices moving as they did on the side that you manually adjusted. Go through and repeat this process for each of the vertex groups that you'd like to mirror. In this example, we'll mirror all of the arm and the hand bones from the right-hand side to the left. To complete the skin wearable, we can add in some materials and textures to give it colors and patterns. For this example, we'll add in four materials: the skin, the hair, the cloth, and also an accent color. To enable more customization options for the avatar, we want the skin material to be tintable in world like other avatars. To achieve this, we'll create a new material called avatar_skin_matte and add an image texture node in the shader editor, where we'll import the avatar skin texture image. As this is the first material we're applying to the model, it's going to show up everywhere. And to control how the texturing appears, we'll UV map the model by selecting the faces we want to unwrap in edit mode, pressing U and selecting a suitable option from the pop-up window. For this example, we'll scale the UVs down to 0 in the UV editor window and map them onto a small section of the image texture. Next, we'll create a new material for the fabric and change the base color to black. We'll adjust the material's properties and assign this material to the faces we want in edit mode by selecting them and pressing Assign in the Materials panel. For the hair, we'll follow a similar process to the skin material by creating a new material named hair_matte and connecting the image texture used for hair in Decentraland. We'll map the hair faces onto the second lighter shade of grey and assign the material to those faces. Lastly, we'll add in a material for a color accent and give it some transparency and glow for fun. We'll create a new material, change the blend mode to alpha blend, adjust the alpha value, and change the base and emissive color to whatever you want. We'll adjust the intensity of the glow and upload our creation to the builder to see how it looks in world. Once you're happy with the item and you want to publish it, you will need some polygon mana, which is like regular mana, but on the Polygon network instead of on the Ethereum blockchain. And you can switch between mana and polygon mana at account.decentraland.org. The cost of publishing an item is currently $150 US, and this goes to the DAO and the curation committee, who check the wearable items in world to ensure that they work properly and they don't violate any of the content policies. Before you can click on the publish button, you need to set a price and a beneficiary for it, then confirm the name of your collection, read and agree to the terms of service, and submit an email address to continue. You'll then pay the submission fees and the item will be sent to the blockchain for review by the curation committee. Once approved, you can put the item on the marketplace by pressing put for sale. So if you're looking to speed up your workflow, definitely consider using the mirror modifier. It can save you a lot of time by automatically mirroring any changes that you make from one side of your model to the other side. Another helpful tip is to have a clear idea of what you want to make from the beginning. This can save you a lot of time and back and forth and prevent you from getting stuck in the middle of the creative process. Keep in mind that geometry is key to creating smooth movement and avoiding clipping issues. So take the time to make sure your geometry is clean and well organized, and use edge loops to control the flow of your mesh. And finally, don't be afraid to experiment and try new things. Sometimes the best creations come from taking risks and pushing the boundaries of what you thought was possible. So have fun, stay curious, and keep making stuff. Before you run off and make your first skin wearable, which I hope you're about to do, there are some issues that you may encounter when making wearables for Decentraland. So I just want to go over them beforehand to avoid you running into any possible roadblocks. One common problem is when you upload your wearable to the builder and suddenly it looks like it's been through a blender, like everything goes everywhere. If this happens, don't panic. It's not something that you've done wrong. It's possible that you've accidentally used the wrong base armature. So double check to make sure that your armature has only 2 foot bones on each side. If there's an extra bone in there, your wearable won't work properly and you'll need to unparent it and reparent it to the correct armature, which you can find in the description below. Obviously, this is a bit annoying if you just spent ages weight painting your wearable, so I'd highly recommend checking that you're using the right armature before you get stuck into that part of the creative process. Clipping is another issue that can crop up quite often. Clipping is what happens when your mesh behaves weirdly during an animation, like a leg poking through a skirt during a dance move. To avoid this, it's important to make sure that your model is watertight with no unnecessary overlapping faces. If you do need overlapping faces for your design to work, then just try and make sure that all the geometry is as even and as equal as possible at all levels. Then you can weight the different layers equally so that they move together and in tandem. And remember, no overlapping faces means no clipping. So if you can avoid that, then it's going to make your life a lot easier. Hopefully by being aware of these potential issues, you're going to have a less frustrating creative process ahead of you. Okay, that's it for this tutorial on making a skin wearable in Decentraland. I hope you found it informative and helpful. Now it's time to put what you've learned into practice and create your own wearables. Remember to have fun and experiment with different concepts and designs. And if you do run into any issues, don't hesitate to reach out on Twitter at @lowpolymodelsw or leave a comment below. If you're interested in learning more about building for Decentraland, make sure to check out our channel and subscribe to stay up to date with our latest videos. You can also follow us on Twitter and Instagram at @lowpolymodelsw for behind the scenes content and learning resources. And if you're looking for professional help with your Decentraland project, be sure to visit our website, lowpolymodelsworld.com, to see examples of our work and learn more about our services. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you in Decentraland!